It can be said that water sustains life and scripture sustains the soul. Both are important to an Alabama-based bottled water company that operates with a higher purpose in mind. Melissa Bowman tells us more.
Before heading to the University of Alabama to play football, Marquise Forge made a promise to his hometown in his speech as class valedictorian.
I made the statement that I don't care where I go and or what I do, if I go off and be successful, I promise to come back and put my time, put my energy and success into Otagaville.
Promise fulfilled. Today, a town of just under 1,000 produces over 1 million bottles of water monthly at a state-of-the-art plant that does everything, from sourcing the water on-site to labeling and packaging.
1186 is here to give this town a newfound hope and pride of being from Otagaville.
1186 is sourced from an aquifer that's existed thousands of years. Mass production was always possible, but Marquise made it happen. A man of deep faith, he was determined, even though he'd never run a bottled water plant.
I've been in the automotive industry since 97, so I've seen plants go up from the ground up. So sometime in life, you ask yourself, you know, why God has me in this place? God has you in those places because somewhere down the road, if you listen, if you get the right opportunity, you obey to use them.
Faith also inspired the name 1186, which refers to the number of chapters in the Bible. Marquise later learned there's actually 1189, but decided to keep the six.
On the sixth day God made man, what better gift to give man than 1186? Say it is, so let it be. And we took off, it wasn't an accident.
Demand is growing. The Alabama legislature designated 1186 the official state water. Beyond Alabama, it's now in seven states and counting.
Every bottle packaged at this plant represents a promise made to a hometown community. No matter how much 1186 expands, its heart will always be in Otagaville.
If I was in another city, I would just be another building, another company, and just be another spot. But here in Otagaville, we're more than a spot.
COO Kelvin Brickhouse agrees. He enjoys being part of a company that generates economic growth and serves the community.
We're trying to give people in Otagaville a job, a decent paying job, something they can be proud of. Hershey, Pennsylvania, everybody know where the chocolate comes from. So I want to be, Otagaville is known for 1186 water.
Born and raised in Otagaville, Latoya Hall loves working for 1186 and loves what it's done for her hometown.
It's put Otagaville on the map. To become the official state water for Alabama, that's amazing. A lot of people did not know that we even existed until they heard about 1186, and now they know.
It's just begun, and I just feel so amazing and blessed to be a part of it.
For Simply Southern, I'm Melissa Bowman.
1186 uses cutting-edge technology. Now, they do everything on-site, including manufacturing the water bottles. Those bottles actually start out as a preform like this, and then after processing, which takes only seconds, they're turned into their distinctive design.
That is an amazing process. Mm-hmm. To find out where you can purchase it, visit 1186water.com and click on product locations. Now, if your community is not listed, you can order online, but you might also want to contact your local retailer to request 1186, since new locations are constantly being added. Now, you've waited for weeks, but the time is now at hand. We'll reveal Alabama's outstanding young farm family for 2020 when Simply Southern continues.
A farmer has to live on faith. We do all we can do, but we can only control so much.
Alabama is the second largest poultry growing state in the nation, so we're trying our best to grow all the corn we can for that.
What we produce not only feeds and clothes all of the United States, but about half of what we make goes on to the world market.
We've been able to improve yields, have some things that can help us produce a better crop. I'm proud of the product we make and proud that I can say I'm an Alabama farmer.
Farm Bureau Bank has built its entire existence around the lifestyle and needs of farmers and ranchers across America. We're here to help grow traditions, give back to agricultural communities, and offer financial convenience for your unique way of life. From sunup to sundown, we are committed to serving you.
A As a farmer, I grow U.S. farm-raised catfish. Doing that, I know it's a safe product, and I enjoy eating it any way my wife likes to cook it. Hi, I'm Luke Smelly, and I'm Alabama 2020 Catfish Farmer of the Year from Greensboro, Alabama. If you haven't tried U.S. farm-raised catfish, you should, because it's delicious. Simple as that.
Hey y'all, I'm Kim Earwood with Alabama Ag in the Classroom. Let's crack open the Rural Dictionary and define a few poultry terms. Baby chickens are called chicks, but you might also hear a farmer call them biddies. A rooster is a male chicken, and a hen is a female chicken. When you get a whole bunch of chickens together, that's called a flock. Chickens are raised for two reasons, eggs and meat. Hens that lay eggs are layers, and chickens grown for meat are called broilers. Broilers are a big deal in Alabama. In fact, we rank second in the nation for broiler production. Now that's something to crow about. To learn more about farming, head over to alabamaaitc.org. This Rural Dictionary is brought to you by Alabama Ag in the Classroom. See you next time!